Hello there, I'm John.
And I'm Aysel. Today we will get you started with your METROTOM 1 3D scanner powered by CT technology.
Feel free to pause at any point to follow along. There's also chapter segments if you wish to skip ahead. Let's get started. So first, let's take a look at what comes with your system itself. Of course, the first thing you'll notice is the 3D scanner sitting right behind you in your measuring room. The METROTOM 1 itself has a small footprint and is roughly 1.8 meters tall, 1.8 meters wide, and a compact 870 millimeters deep. This means that the system can be installed through standard double doors very easily. Additionally, your system will come with several fixturing plates that look just like this for putting any scanning items into the system, as well as a calibration object looking like this. Moving forward, we'll look deeper into fixturing and calibration in a future video. Additionally, there's no need for user installation, as your METROTOM 1 will be installed upon arrival by the well-trained ZEISS service team. On top of that, a powerful PC workstation will accompany your METROTOM 1, which optimizes evaluation speed.
To get started, let's make sure our METROTOM 1 and PC workstation are both powered on. The METROTOM 1 is powered on by rotating the master switch on the left side on the system. While the METROTOM 1 does its initial power-up cycle, let's take a look at the rest of the scanner control hardware that we can interact with.
So starting from the left to right on the front of the system, the first thing we see is a key switch. This is the master switch for the X-ray tube itself. When switched into the on position, the system will be ready for use. If you want to make sure that the system is only operated by a certain personnel, this key can be removed. If we continue to the right, we notice three buttons. The first has a lock symbol underneath. When this is lit up, the door is locked and ready for use. You must press this whenever you wish to unlock and open the door. The next button along the way is the refresh button. You should see it flashing now. This indicates that the system has completed its initial power-up cycle and is ready to carry on with the warm-up. Let's go ahead and press it now. You'll need to press this button anytime you close the door. This will lock the door and prepare the system to begin scanning. The last of these three white buttons is the power button. This button can't actually be pressed. It simply indicates that the system is on and in functioning condition. The final and most obvious of the hardware control elements is the bright red emergency button. I think this one actually explains itself, so I won't go into detail.
Now that we have taken the time to introduce you to the scanner control hardware, our X-ray tube is ready to warm up for use. To get started, we can open the ZEISS INSPECT software on our workstation to initialize the system. This button connects the software with your METROTOM 1. Once the button becomes gray to indicate a connection, we can move to the warm-up button, which is the first one on our workflow rhythm. After clicking warm-up, we will indicate the voltage we would like our system to warm up to. To easily get every inspection done, let's warm up to the maximum amount. As the warm-up begins, you will notice the large orange light on the front of the system is activated. When the system has completed its warm-up, the light will turn off and your system will be ready to use for the day. To confirm the warm-up was successful and get an overview of the rest of the system information, we can click on the system status in the top right anytime. Once open, you will notice a handful of status indicators. From here, we can make sure that all status indicators show a green check mark. And the max KV is 160. This tells us that we are ready to begin scanning parts. One area of the status bar you will notice is the calibration status.
So this last step of setup is optional, but recommended to save time later. By the nature of CT scanning, we actually need to detect our reference image each day before we begin scanning. This actually ensures the sharpest data possible. Let's go ahead and see how it's done. You can access this from acquisition, measurement, capture flat field correction data. We simply input the recommended plastic scan settings and continue on. The software will quickly make sure nothing is on the rotation table and complete the operation. All right, guys, with that, we're all set up and ready to scan.
If you experience anything different from what you've seen here, or if you have any questions about getting started on your METROTOM 1, please visit handsonmetrology.com. For more getting started information, please check out our other videos. Thanks for watching and see you next time.